Students, in one of my previous videos, I discussed about trick for VBT. Many students ask me how to identify the ligand, whether it is a strong field or weak field. In today's session, I am going to discuss the trick to identify whether the ligand is a strong field ligand or weak field ligand. This is very important in coordination compound chapter to know about the strength of the ligand. In this session, without use of the spectrochemical series, I am going to discuss the trick so that you can identify the strength of the ligand, whether it is a strong field or weak field. Let us start our session. Ligands in which donor atoms are halogens, oxygen or sulfur. Generally, these are, if donor atoms in the ligands, they are weak ligands. What are weak ligands, students? If the ligand having the donor atom, if the donor atom is halogen or oxygen or sulfur, that acts as a weak ligands. Let us see some examples so that you understand better. F minus, weak field or strong field? It is a weak field ligand. Why? Because it is a halogen. Cl minus, Br minus, I minus, all these are halogens. So these are weak field ligands. And OH minus, oxygen is a donor. So it is a weak field ligand. SCN minus, actually it is a bidentate ligand. Whenever you see the bidentate ligand, you have to see the donor atoms. If sulfur is a donor atom, it is a weak field ligand. Sulfur is a donor atom, it is a weak field ligand. Next, oxalate ion. Here oxygen, if you see the oxalate ion structure, COO minus, COO minus. It is also a bidentate ligand. It is a bidentate ligand. Oxygen is the donor. These two oxygens donate to the metal. And here oxygen is a donor, so it is also a weak field ligand. Let us see about strong field ligands. Ligands in which donor atoms are carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, generally acts as strong field ligands. What students? They should have carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, then they act as a strong field ligands. Let us see some examples. CN minus. In CN minus, actually a CN is a ambidentate ligand. Either it can act as a nitrogen can be a donor or carbon can be a donor. If carbon is a donor, then you can identify like this. The bonding will be like this. Then it is a strong field ligand. If nitrogen is a donor, NC, it is also a strong field ligand. NC. CO. Carbon is a donor in CO, so it is a strong field ligand. Ammonia, nitrogen is a donor, so it is a strong field ligand. Ethylene diamine or ethane 1,2 diamine, its structure is CH2, CH2, NH2, NH2. Nitrogen is having lone pair. This lone pair, it donates to the metal and it forms a bond. Right, and this is also a bidentate ligand, and here the donor is nitrogen, so it is a strong ligand. Dimethyl glyoxylate ion, it is also a strong ligand. Its structure is CO minus, CH2, NH2. If nitrogen is the donor, then it is a strong ligand. EDTA. EDTA, nitrogen is the donor. It is a strong ligand. Because of the more number of chelate rings which are present in EDTA, it acts as a strong ligand. Triphenylphosphine, PPH3. Phosphorus having lone pair, it donates. So, phosphorus is there, it is a strong ligand. PME thrice, trimethylphosphine. It is also a strong field ligand because it contains a phosphorus. Yes, let us see the summary ones. Ligands in which the donor atoms are having halogens, oxygen or sulfur, they act as a weak ligands. Wherever the donors are there, halogen, oxygen and sulfur, they are weak ligands. Whenever they have carbon, nitrogen and phosphorus as the donors, then they are strong field ligands. This is very important, students, because many gets the confusion whether it is strong field or weak field. Without knowing that, you cannot do VBT, you cannot do CFT questions. These are most important in coordination compounds. So I hope this video helps you. Let us see one question. Test yourself. Test yourself question. Which of the following is a strong field ligand? SCN minus. See here, SCN minus sulfur is the donor. OCN minus. In this, oxygen is the donor. Ma'am, how to identify which is the donor means they give the complex like CO, NH3, 5, OCN, 2 plus. Suppose if this is the complex, here oxygen is the donor. CNO, it is a bidentate ligand, means ambidentate, two donor atoms will be present. Yes, in this complex same, both are same, but here oxygen is the donor, here carbon is the donor. Okay, if oxygen is the donor, it is a weak field. If carbon is the donor, it is a strong field. You have to identify, and based on that you have to do CFT and VBT. Here oxygen is the donor, ONO, oxygen is the donor and NO2 nitrogen is the donor. Identify the strong field ligand. That is your question. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give like. If possible, try to share with your friends.